Welcome to FDA's presentation on implementing supply chain security requirements under the Drug Supply Chain Security Act, or DSCSA, the stabilization period and expectations. My name is Dr. Leigh Verbois, and I am the Director of the Office of Drug Security, Integrity and Response in FDA's Center for Drug Evaluation and Research in the Office of Compliance. Today, I will highlight efforts to implement supply chain security requirements under the Drug Supply Chain Security Act, which help to improve the integrity of the drug supply chain and protect patients from receiving potentially harmful products. Everything that I will cover in this presentation is available on FDA's website. You can specifically search for DSCSA to find our main DSCSA webpage that has links to relevant information. Today, I'm going to review the Drug Supply Chain Security Act implementation and expectations for trading partners to achieve interoperable electronic tracing of products at the package level, focusing on the stabilization period. While many of you are familiar with this, I am reminding everyone of the overarching goals of the Drug Supply Chain Security Act, which was established November 27, 2013. The DSCSA outlines steps to achieve an interoperable electronic tracing of products at the package level to identify and trace certain prescription drugs as they are distributed in the United States. It enhances trading partner and regulators' ability to help protect consumers from exposure to drugs that may be counterfeit, stolen, contaminated, or otherwise harmful, including through improved detection and removal of potentially dangerous drugs from the supply chain. And DSCSA directs FDA to establish a national licensure standard for wholesale drug distributors and third-party logistics providers. Since the passage of DSCSA, significant progress has been achieved in implementation. Lot-level product tracing and verification were implemented in 2015. In addition to authorized trading partner requirements, product identifiers that include unique serial numbers are now on DSCSA compliant products since 2018. And in the same year, verification requirements changed to the package level. And now we're in 2023, where the enhanced drug distribution security requirements will go into effect this November. But our slide shows 2023 plus. 2023 plus refers to current requirements that are in effect and remain in effect after November 2023. This includes authorized trading partner requirements, product identifier, and verification. We also have a new enhanced product tracing and verification at the package level. These are also known as the requirements for the enhanced drug distribution security. These become effective November 27, 2023, and we will discuss these further in the presentation. It is important to reiterate the previous and new requirements will remain in effect November 27, 2023 and beyond. It is important for me to highlight key aspects of the enhanced drug distribution security requirements as outlined in the Drug Supply Chain Security Act, specifically Section 582G1 of the Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act. I am highlighting key language in light blue font on the slide. The data exchange involving transaction information, or TI, and transaction statement, or TS, shall be in a secure, interoperable electronic manner. This gets us to all electronic. Transaction information is required to include the product identifier. This means that transaction information includes the serial number. And trading partners should have systems and processes to verify this at the package level and have systems and processes to promptly respond to requests for transaction information or transaction statements from the Food and Drug Administration or other appropriate federal and state officials. These systems should be able to promptly facilitate the gathering of transaction information for each transaction going back to the manufacturer. And lastly, saleable returns should only be accepted if you can associate the saleable return to its transaction information forged transaction statements. These requirements establish an interoperable electronic tracing of products at the package level, and this is the goal of the Drug Supply Chain Security Act. In August of 2023, FDA issued a compliance policy guidance regarding our enforcement of the enhanced drug distribution security requirements under Section 582G1 of the Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act, which I just highlighted on the previous slide. The guidance describes FDA's compliance policies regarding enforcement of the enhanced drug distribution security requirements under this section that go into effect November 27, 2023. The guidance outlines that we are accommodating an additional 1 year that might be needed to continue to develop and refine appropriate systems and processes to conduct interoperable electronic tracing at the package level to achieve robust supply chain security under the DSCSA while helping to achieve continued patient access to prescription drugs. Basically, this means FDA does not intend to take action to enforce the enhanced drug distribution security requirements until November 27, 2024. Specifics are outlined in the guidance. In addition, a second compliance policy related to wholesale distributor verification of saleable returns and dispenser verification was issued soon after to align with the compliance policies in the previous guidance regarding enhanced drug distribution security requirements. This guidance revises and extends the 2020 compliance policies for an additional year regarding an wholesale distributor verification of saleable return drug products and dispenser verifications when investigating suspect or illegitimate products. This allows wholesale distributors to focus resources on efforts to implement the enhanced drug security requirements. Wholesale distributors can increase their efficiency by incorporating the saleable return verification requirements into the enhanced verification required by enhanced drug distribution security instead of developing separate processes or infrastructures. Extending the 2020 compliance policies also accommodates the additional time that may be needed for wholesale distributors to test their ability to verify saleable returns using real-time volume involving all trading partners. Basically, FDA does not intend to take action against wholesale distributors who do not, prior to November 27, 2024, verify the product identifier prior to further distributing saleable return products as required by the Act. FDA does not intend to take action before November 27, 2024 against dispensers who do not verify the product identifier of suspect product as required by the Act. And FDA does not intend to take action before November 27, 2024 against dispensers who do not verify the product identifiers of illegitimate product that are in the subject of notification from FDA or trading partners as required by Section 582D4B3. With the compliance policies in these two guidances, we should focus on November 2023 and beyond. Instead of 2023+, we really need to think of this as the stabilization period. During the stabilization period, trading partners should use this additional time to implement, troubleshoot, and mature their systems and processes while supporting the continued availability of products to patients. The compliance policies should not be viewed as providing justification for delaying efforts by trading partners to implement the enhanced drug distribution security requirements that are required under the Act. And the Food and Drug Administration urges trading partners to continue their efforts to implement the necessary measures to satisfy the enhanced drug distribution security requirements under the Act. Trading partners should understand the importance of this stabilization period. They should use this time to build and validate interoperable systems and processes, to manage products and data, and ensure the continuity of the supply chain and product availability to patients to protect health. Trading partners should use current methods to exchange and store documentation about products and their ownership, and investigate and report suspect and illegitimate product and handle saleable returns. So now our DSCSA implementation includes this critical stabilization period from November 2023 to November 2024 for trading partners to implement, troubleshoot, and mature their systems and processes while supporting the continued availability of products to patients. The target for the interoperable electronic product tracing to the package level is now November 20, 2024. After the stabilization period, we expect the pharmaceutical distribution supply chain to be able to electronically exchange data for product tracing and verification requirements, in addition to responding to information requests from FDA and promptly facilitating the gathering of transaction information back to the manufacturer when investigating suspect and illegitimate products. FDA continues and will continue to monitor trading partner readiness to meet the enhanced drug distribution security requirements under Section 582(g)(1) during and after the period of the compliance policies that I previously discussed. FDA is committed to supporting the efforts of trading partners to achieve enhanced drug distribution security. In August of 2023, we also finalized the draft guidance regarding waivers, exceptions, and exemptions from certain DSCSA requirements in Section 582 of the Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act. The guidance describes a process for how trading partners or other stakeholders may request a waiver, exemption, or exception from certain DSCSA requirements, as well as other considerations FDA will apply to evaluate such requests and determine FDA-initiated exceptions and exemptions. The guidance also includes the process FDA intends to follow every 2 years to review and make determinations on the appropriateness of renewing a previously approved waiver, exception, or exemption where applicable. It's important to note that FDA also has the authority under Section 582(a)(3) of the Act to grant exemptions from certain requirements in Section 582 when the agency determines that the exemption is appropriate to maintain public health or otherwise appropriate. Since the enactment of DSCSA in 2013, FDA has issued several guidances for industry to provide agency recommendations and clarifications to help trading partners with understanding terms and requirements to support implementation. Additional key final guidances that we have recently issued include the enhanced drug distribution security at the package level under DSCSA in August of 2023. This guidance document clarifies the enhanced drug distribution security requirements under Section 582(g)(1) of the Act and makes recommendations with respect to the system attributes necessary to enable secure tracing of the product at the package level, including allowing for the use of verification, inference, and aggregation as necessary. This guidance document finalizes a draft guidance document that was issued in June of 2021. FDA considers these recommendations to be important in assisting in implementing the robust supply chain security envisioned under DSCSA. Additionally, we issued a guidance document entitled Standards for the Interoperable Exchange of Information for Tracing of Certain Human Finished Prescription Drugs in September of 2023. This guidance document identifies the standards necessary to facilitate adoption of secure, interoperable electronic data exchange among the pharmaceutical distribution supply chain and clarifies the trading partners' products and transactions subject to such standards. There is a lot of useful information in these guidances. Therefore, please refer to the guidances for specific details. Additionally, FDA continues to work on finalizing several important draft guidances. As I finish up my presentation, I want to re-emphasize important elements of the stabilization period. During the stabilization period established by the August 2023 compliance policies, from November 2023 to November 2024, FDA will work with trading partners to continue implementation efforts. While November 27, 2023 is a key implementation date, these requirements will continue beyond 2023. Trading partners should use the stabilization period to build and validate interoperable systems and processes and manage products and data to ensure continuity of the supply chain and product availability to patients. Trading partners should use current methods to exchange and store documentation about products in their chain of ownership. They should investigate and report suspect and illegitimate product and handle saleable returns. FDA is also committed to complete the small dispenser assessment and, if needed, establish timelines for compliance by small businesses and a process for dispensers to request a waiver for such requirements. FDA is also committed to stakeholder engagement, such as through public meetings or our public-private partnership with the Partnership for DSCSA Governance. And we're continuing to work to finalize the proposed rule for national standards of licensure of wholesale distributors and 3PLs and establish a federal licensing program. We encourage trading partners to continue implementing enhanced drug distribution security requirements. To coordinate within your company, different departments within your organizations will likely need to work together. We encourage you to work with your trading partners to exchange electronic data. Interoperability is not easy and requires coordination with your trading partners for data exchange. We encourage you to become familiar with FDA guidances. There are many guidances, but these provide the agency's recommendations and current thinking. And we encourage you to stay engaged. We hope to see you at FDA meetings, but also encourage stakeholders to participate in other industry-led conferences and workshops. Engagement and coordination are key to successful implementation of DSCSA requirements. We must all be vigilant to secure the supply chain, to make sure we protect U.S. patients from receiving illegitimate products. As I wrap up today, here's a resource slide specifically for DSCSA resources. Our main DSCSA webpage has links to all the information I have covered in today's presentation. This includes guidances for industry and the proposed regulations, a link to the waivers, exceptions, and exemptions request webpage, links to our public meetings, a helpful mechanism to sign up for email updates on the DSCSA, and lastly, ways to connect with our team directly. Thank you and have a great day.